We have with us Mr. Ajay Piramal, Chairman of Piramal Group. Sir, congratulations on completing the QIP. To begin with, can you just give us an idea of what is the kind of coupon rate you're going to offer to the investors as part of the CCD?
So this is actually the first time a CCD in the QIP format has been done. The coupon rate will be 7.9%.
And it's expected to convert within 18 months. Do you expect investors would convert much earlier than the 18 months?
I don't know. It's actually the option is left with the investors. So it's up to them whenever they want to convert. We have most of the investors that I've seen are long-term investors. So I don't see many of them converting prior to that.
Can you give us a color of the kind of investors that has come in and from the region they have come in, and how many times book were you able to see the demand?
So the investors have come in from half of the book will be from North America. We have about 35% from Asia. The rest is from Europe. I think that's the amount of detail this today that I can share with you. I can also share that the quality of investors that come in is really high quality. Some of these are pension funds, others who have an interest in actually investing in India for the long term, and other very high quality names. So this list, along with the existing shareholders, will provide us with actually a very good set of investors, which could be partners with us not only today, but as we go ahead into the future. And as and when we require funds, I think they would be standing side by side.
Is it entirely foreign investors, or you have domestic institutions as well participating in it?
About 80 to 85% will be foreign investors. There are also domestic investors too.
Can you share us the dilution part of it? When the dilution happens eventually in 18 months, what is the kind of dilution that will happen, including the rights issue, which is of 2,000 crores?
So rights issue will not be dilutive because all the existing shareholders will get it in proportion. This will be about 10% in that region.
And in the rights issue, I think you have underwriting nearly 90-95%, right?
Correct. So we really believe that the story of the company is good. And to show that our confidence is there in the company, we are underwriting it to the 90%. What's also actually unique in our story has been that ever since we've entered this business in 88, since 88, we have not sold any shares. We have only actually in some ways added to it because we believe that the long-term story still is good.
You spoke about the fact that the proceeds would be used largely for financial services. Can you give us a breakup of how you plan to use them for financial services?
In financial services, one, we have a wholesale book, which has been growing rapidly, which has a good quality. So that gives us the confidence that we can continue to invest in growing this book. So some funds will go towards that. In addition, we have just announced recently the housing finance company, and we will use funds for that. We've also got a fund for stressed assets, so that's another area that we will put in funds.
How much funds would it be for housing finance and stressed assets?
Housing finance will need 1,000 crores, and stressed assets, $100 million, so 650 crores.
What's happening? Because I think you were working on a couple of stressed assets. You were supposed to close at least two by the end of the financial year. Where are we on that?
We are working on many assets. Let's see where we... So we are working on it, which we will close, when we will close, it's difficult to say at this stage. But yeah, we are working on more than two, let's say.
In which sectors do you see most of them
coming? We have said we will do 7-8 broad sectors, which includes textiles, it includes steel, auto ancillaries, pharmaceuticals, cement, so we will look at those.
You also said very interesting stuff here, you know, that pharma space is looking interesting. Does the group wants to go into pharma in a big way again?
So actually, we are quite big in pharma itself,
even today. Not the one traditional
pharma. We are not in the domestic formulation space. We have a non-compete with Abbott till 2018, and in letter and spirit, we will honor that.
And after that, you would look at?
After that, we'll see.
What about stress assets coming in this space for you?
So most of the stress assets in pharma are not really in branded generic space. They are more in the APIs and all. So that we can look at even now. That we are allowed to.
Okay. You know, housing finance, of late we have seen, you know, a slowdown in housing finance because multiple regulations coming in that space. Where do you see that business going in? We have seen a lot of companies now coming into the housing finance sector as well.
So I think in housing finance, we believe that we have a unique advantage. One is that we understand the house, the whole market of construction as real estate, because we've been we are lenders in it at one hand. In another entity, we also do development. So our understanding of that space is probably better than what many other competition has. Besides that, we have very strong relationships with all the A-class developers in the large cities. And that also, housing we've seen is not a necessarily just a B2C business, but it's a B2B2C business. In other words, the middle person, the developer also has a key role to play in influencing a housing loan decision. And that's where our close relationships with developers also helps. The third thing is that we have a very solid group called BrickX, which are people who actually work in the market, who have close connections, who have DSAs and close connections, which again is an advantage. So overall, we think that we should make a, and the what I see in the first month of launch, actually we launched it only in the first week of September, has been a good book of 200 crores. So we are optimistic about it.
And what about the construction financing space? Because that's, it's expected to see some consolidation, right, with RERA coming in, more regulatory watch over it. And you were on record saying that, you know, we will see some kind of a consolidation of, and JDs would be the way to go forward. Are you seeing some traction there?
So there's a lot of consolidation taking place because, as you've said, RERA has meant, actually more than anything else, RERA has meant that many of the people are worried about, you know, what the liabilities could be because of RERA. And hence, the bigger people are getting in some ways stronger and bigger, and the marginal players are being facing some stress. And because of that, you're seeing that people who till now were doing development are now saying that, okay, if we have land, let's just do a JDA, give it to somebody else who's much, you know, stronger, better to do it.
Finally, Mr. Piramal, you know, you've been on record saying that in the midterm, you would like, you know, the business to demerge financial services as a separate company and your other business as a separate company. When you say midterm, is there a way, are you looking at sizes or for your financial services business before you decide whether now it's time to grow, stand on its own, or what exactly when you say?
No, I think when I say midterm, I'll say it's a combination of factors. It's not going to be one. It'll be depend on what the environment is like, what the growth prospects are, what the size of the business is. So it's many factors together that will differ.
Mr. Piramal, thank you very much, and wish you a very happy Diwali.
Thank you. Happy Diwali to you and your viewers.